A reading from the Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Now when Jesus came into the district of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, "Who do people say that the Son of Man is?" And they said, "Some say John the Baptist, but others Elijah, and still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter answered, "You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God." And Jesus answered him, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father in heaven. And I tell you, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not prevail against it. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. Please sit. Yesterday was the feast of the Confession of St. Peter, of which today's Gospel reading speaks. What we find in today's reading is probably the most important question that Jesus asked his disciples. And it's probably the most important question there is. Who do people say that the Son of Man is? And the way we answer that question is just as important as the question that is being asked. Who is Jesus the Christ? Better yet, who is Jesus Christ to you? And the people back then had many answers. They were not sure who he was. Some thought he was John the Baptizer, Elijah, Jeremiah, or one of the prophets. They were not sure. He had to be at least a prophet based on the things he said and the things he did, and one who was from before. And even today, people are still unsure as to whom Jesus is. Persons today still have many answers as to who is this Son of Man. And persons are unsure as to whether Jesus is truly Lord and Savior, whether he was just a baby who was born in a manger, whether he is some imaginary or fictitious person the church has simply made up to make people believe he is God. But Peter got it right. And got it correct in today's reading. And that is good of Peter because many times he doesn't get it right. Peter got it wrong in denying Jesus just before his crucifixion. Peter will get it wrong just a few verses later in this very same chapter, when Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and undergo great suffering at the hands of the religious leaders, and that he will be killed and on the third day he will rise from the dead. And Peter, in true Peter fashion, is quick to answer. He took Jesus aside, rebuked him, and said, "God forbid it, Lord. This must never happen to you." To which Jesus responded, "Get behind me, Satan. You are a stumbling block to me, for you are setting your mind not on divine things, but on human things." So yes, in today's passage itself, Peter got it right. He got it correct in this case. And the people back then got it wrong as to whom Jesus is. Peter's confession, his answer that Jesus is the Messiah, the Christ, the Son of the living God, is exactly right. Jesus, the Christ, is the Messiah, the anointed one, the one whom God promised to send to be our Lord and Savior, to redeem his people from their sin. Jesus, the Son of the living God, is God incarnate. He is himself God in human flesh. But how does Peter, who often gets it so wrong, get it right on this occasion? And Jesus himself discloses it when he says, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father in heaven." Peter didn't hear it from anyone, neither did he figure it out on his own. It was revealed to him. God the Father revealed it to him. It was God who gave him the answer in that moment of faith. And even in spite of his failings and doubts of the past, Peter will come to believe that Jesus was truly who he said he was, although he will still not understand what all that meant. Peter believed Jesus was who he was, the Christ, the Messiah, the Son of the living God. But Jesus was himself God. And it was faith that brought him to believe. It was because of his faith that the Father revealed it to him. And from this point on, Peter's name will change from Simon, son of Jonah, which is what he was originally called. The persons in those days were identified by their parents. And even in our own time, years ago, it was the same. And even Jesus was referred to as the son of Joseph in John's Gospel. Nevertheless, Simon will become Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, Jesus says. And many believe that when Jesus says this about Peter, that he is referring to Peter as the rock. Peter meaning Petros and rock meaning Petra. But maybe what Jesus is really saying is that the rock is not necessarily Peter himself, although it could be. But what Peter said, "You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God," is what is the rock. And as a result, the rock of the church is Christ himself, the one whom God sent to be our Lord and Savior, the one who is the Son of the living God, God himself in human flesh. The reality that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God, Jesus is saying that he will build his church on that truth. The truth of what Peter said. You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God. And on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not prevail against it. Whose church it is? Jesus' church. Christ's church. Our Lord's church. Our Savior's church. I will build my church, Jesus said. Jesus is building his church. He is the one who is building it numerically and spiritually and even financially. He is the one building it into the hearts and minds of persons who believe. And we are called not to grow the church, not to add people to the church, but to proclaim the gospel, to tell others about the Word of God, to tell others what Jesus has done for us in our lives, and then let God do the rest. We need to believe that God will keep his promise of building his church, not yours, but his. Not mine, but his. Not ours, but his. And his church will not fail because it is his church. Yes, some local churches may cease to exist in the form they once were, but the church universal will always continue. And so we are to remain committed to Christ's church and the church here at All Saints. Remember that the church is God's people. And so we are to continue loving God's people, God's children, our brothers and sisters in Christ, and to love each other fervently. Continue to deepen and to grow spiritually in our lives, and to set the example of Christ, both in word and example, as we tell others about Him. For through us, others can come to faith in God, as He reveals Himself to them. May we, like Peter, be able to boldly answer, to boldly confess, the most important question in our lives about Jesus. You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God.